Next, new songs from an American classic. Jeffrey Brown visited Judy Collins to hear a preview of her 51st album being released tomorrow, along with a tour with more than 100 dates.
Judy Collins has been making beautiful music since the early 1960s, and since 1967, writing her own songs. In her New York apartment recently, she played a new one for us.
I really thought of myself not as a singer in the beginning. I really thought of myself as a storyteller.
Oh, really? Meaning that it was all about the story?
It was.
Many years later, at age 77, the stories and songs continue. And for her latest album, titled Silver Skies Blue, Collins has taken a new step, co-writing an entire record with another artist, 36-year-old Ari Hest. Collins grew up in a musical family. Her father, blind from age 4, was a singer and radio host who inspired her with Irish ballads, Rodgers and Hammerstein, and much more. She studied classical piano and then discovered and became part of a growing folk music scene that was infused with social activism.
I learned to sing along the way. So the songs provided me with a living, with entertainment, education, singing lessons, and adventure throughout my whole career, really.
One of the things that you, of course, became so well known for is bringing songs that other people wrote to the attention of a general audience.
I was desperate to sing great songs, the kind of classic songs that I'd been raised with. This was the burgeoning of the great folk music revival.
Yeah.
And I was in the village, so I learned Woody and I learned Pete. I learned all their great songs. And when I came to New York,
Woody Guthrie, Pete Seeger, and on and on, yeah.
I was sitting in the middle of this incredible burgeoning of beauty and art and fantasy and also politically and socially important songs. I just would walk around the village and Tom Paxson would come along and say, "Oh, hi, I just wrote this song, Bottle of Wine, Fruit on the Vine. Why don't you sing it?" Dylan was just starting in 61 here in New York, and I went to hear him at Town Hall and said, "I have to sing Masters of War and I have to sing The Lonesome Death of Hattie Carroll," one of the great songs to come out of that era.
Over the years, she'd become renowned for her versions of classics, such as Amazing Grace, sung here at Drumoland Castle in Ireland. And at the Metropolitan Museum, Stephen Sondheim's Send in the Clowns.
One who keeps tearing around, one who can't move.
How do you think of what it is that you're doing when it's someone else's song?
You have to apply the same criteria to the songs that you write as well as the songs that you sing of other people. They all have to somehow become, they have to become Judy Collins songs.
Your song.
Yeah. You have to make them into that somehow. And that's magical. And also which songs you choose is magical because you don't know what. It's falling in love. If you're falling in love, you don't know why. I mean, sure he has blue eyes or sure he has green eyes, but you don't know what it is that really is the chemistry. It's the same thing with the song.
Can you give me an example?
In the early things, well, things like Turn, 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 of course. I heard that and immediately wanted to sing it ever since I heard it. As a 15-year-old. To everything turn,
there is a season, turn, 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 and a time to every voice and every. There's been great success, including 4 gold and 2 platinum albums. But over the years, Collins has also faced well-documented challenges. Depression, bulimia, the suicide of her son, a long fight with alcoholism.
Recovering alcoholic. In fact, today is my anniversary.
Oh.
38 years.
Wow.
When I have had troubles, I have been able to go into my music and my writing to be able to find my way through those things.
The sweetness of those afternoons.
But That, too, was threatened when she developed problems with her vocal cords that eventually required surgery.
Terrifying. I spent a number of years just horrified with what was I going to do if I couldn't perform.
I see you do a lot of speaking
on
the subject of healing, the healing power of art and music.
I would say that my own life has been very impacted by the fact that I'm a working musician, so I'm involved with music, with writing it, playing it, practicing it, performing it, and it really does. That 2 hours when I'm on stage is a meditation in a way. You can't do a lot when you're singing except to be present.
Still on stage, Judy Collins and her new musical partner Ari Hest are now in the midst of a national tour. From New York, I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.
Stop there.